Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales. I'm the RPG Chick, switching to Ivo. She's got all these goodies now that Wilbur has given her. Like fireplace travel powder.
There are normally good reasons for distrusting magical objects and substances. However, fireplace travel powder has been used by mages for a long time. Accidents only tend to happen when several mages try to appear in a fireplace that's too small.
Oh my god, I could imagine. And we got a magic slate.
A more than strange looking thing, but as long as it can get me into the staff room, I don't mind.
And a creepy doll.
Ooh, that doll's voice makes the hairs on my neck stand on end.
They might like it. So I wonder if they might know a good joke.
Hi, you two.
Oh, hello.
Wilbur needs a joke to make the statue of the god of funny jokes or something like that laugh. You don't by any chance know any good jokes, do you?
Don't ask me why, but Wilbur wants to learn a few good jokes. Do you know any?
But of course.
Mm-hmm.
After being examined, the patient asks, "Doctor, is there anything you can do for me?" To which the doctor replies, "Certainly, I'll prescribe you a couple of mud baths. And they'll help." "Of course," the doctor says. "It'll help you to get used to the feeling of being buried."
Oh, I still remember the damp earth. For a long time, I thought if only you'd let yourself be cremated.
Oh, okay. Thanks.
You know all about ghosts, don't you?
I bet you know all about ghosts, don't you?
I used to share a flat with some.
Do you happen to know how to cast a spell on a ghost?
No idea. But I do know that ghosts don't stick to cleaning rosters, and they don't use doors, and that could really give you a terrible shock.
I've got to go now. Bye, you two.
Bye.
Bye.
I'll let them have some time on their own. They've got to make a decision about where they're going to spend their life together. Hi, you two.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello. Let's go down here. See if our friends here can help us. Well, we can't even select Nate, or N8, like she likes to call him, because she doesn't even like the name Nate anymore. Let's talk to Zloth and Blount.
Hello, Zloth, Blount.
Ah, Princess Iva.
I need a joke.
This might seem a little bit weird, but could you please tell me a joke?
Why weird? A joke can lift the spirits in times of great adversity.
True.
No joke! No joke!
Oh, Blout, your jokes are always so lewd.
That's why good jokes. Two statues stand in park, face each other for hundreds of years. One be young man, other be young woman. Both is naked.
Here we go again.
Then God appear. He says, "I grant you biggest wish. Both can leave plinth for 1 hour. Both disappear in bushes, rustling, whispering, giggling. Man pants, 10 minutes left." She reply, "Okay. Now you hold pigeon and I shit on it."
Oh my god. Oh, she teleported.
Princess? Really?
Oh, apologies.
Is that a little unseemly? Well, that might be the one they want because they're statues, so, you know, they might be able to, I don't know. I don't know what the word I'm looking for. They might be able to, blank with that. Oh man, it must be late. I can't find my words. It's kind of like commiserate, but oh my god, I can't think. They might be able to identify with that. Thank you. Do you perhaps know another joke?
You don't happen to have another joke for me, do you?
No, lots more jokes with naked people.
The princess doesn't want to hear them.
Yeah, she didn't say
anyway,
that.
Anyway, you've already had your turn. Now I will tell a real joke.
Oh, a real joke.
The town guard asks the mage head of a two-headed ogre, "So you deny breaking a fence post in two on your brother's head?" To which the ogre replies, "I can't deny that, but I didn't do it on purpose." "So you didn't intend to hit him?" "Oh, I did, but I didn't intend to break the fence post in the process."
You're very funny.
Of course it's funny.
Thanks very much for the jokes, Loth. I will endeavor to remember it.
You see.
That's funny. Blout knows the better jokes. Do you know how to cast a spell on ghosts?
I could do with knowing how to cast a spell on a ghost. Do you know anything about that?
I know. Very scared of ghosts.
As you know, one fears nothing more than the unknown. And if one knows nothing, one fears everything.
Ghosts evil. Steal Blout socks. But always just left one.
Huh. Of course, it's always just our left socks that are missing. That's your side. I look after my socks.
So what about ghost spells, then?
I know you can keep ghosts at bay with certain symbols.
Blout has protector amulet with symbols on.
Can I have the amulet, Blout?
About the amulet.
Protect me from ghosts. Works good. Not attacked by ghosts so far.
Could I borrow it, please?
No. Then Blout unprotected.
The amulet depicts the magic circle, but it's not magical. Blout got it from the bargain bin for 3 copper pieces.
It could still come in useful.
It's mine! Won't give.
I would try to persuade him, but it's hopeless. Hmm. He's almost as scared of ghosts as he is of the young Van Buren.
That's exactly what I was thinking. Perhaps I can offer you something in exchange for the amulet.
Blout, how about I give you something in exchange for the amulet?
Creepy doll?
I've got a stone which protects you from the evil eye. Ever since I've had it, I've not been hit by any curses.
Give you 5 gold pieces for it.
No.
I don't want to sell the stone. I want to swap it for your amulet.
But Blout want to be protected from ghosts and evil eye.
I need that amulet really urgently. Well, oh no, he says it's not even magical.
A life could depend on you giving me that amulet.
Blout's life depend on keeping it. Perhaps ghosts come tonight.
This isn't going to work. A life could depend...
Blout's pet.
Well, thank you.
Thanks for the chat.
You were like a beacon of light in the darkness of night, Princess.
What would you want? Maybe I could use this with the travel powder. Let's look back up here first, though. Technically, that is a fireplace. If there's anything you can do from over here, but you never know.
No entry.
Listen.
I have to deliver these magical slates.
The council leader Van Buren ordered a magical slate.
So?
I meant to deliver it.
So?
I need to get into her office.
Van Buren isn't there.
I know. I just have to leave it on her desk.
How are you going to do that without her head?
Oh, forget it.
I have a delivery for Chantal Van Buren.
I have to drop this off.
What is it?
A present for Chantal Van Buren.
Its head turns around.
Take it away!
I would have taken it into the staff room, but as you don't want to let me in there...
Are you my mummy?
No.
I love you.
Make it stop!
It's coming. It's coming.
Shall we sing a song? Oh, how I love having a friend.
Turn it off!
Oh, she'll stop of her own accord in a few days' time.
I need putty.
I'll smash it!
And what would the little Chantel say about you destroying her new toy?
Yeah.
You know, Chantel, the queen of pink and fluffy.
Blackmail, eh?
Oh, yeah.
That ain't gonna work with me.
We'll see about that.
Ha! I can't hear anything!
We won something there?
Grumda, you are the worst guard in the world. He can't hear anything anymore. Grumda! Will you please let me into the staff room? Will you?
Alright, so... we just accomplished that he can't hear. Hold up.
No entry!
Also, because he's deaf, we can't hear his axe slamming down. I can't use it on anything.
A more than strange-looking thing, but as long as...
I don't think it can. Okay. What was that other thing I had to do? Oh, that fireplace. Okay.
As I know, you just need to throw a bit of this powder into the fireplace and then get in it.
You gotta get in that? Go ahead.
Well, I could throw the powder into the fire, but what then? How do I make sure that I come out exactly where I want to come out?
You have to think about where you want to go. Alright, that doesn't help very much. Let's go talk to Wilbur.
Wilbur?
Yes?
Heard about the one about a patient and a doctor?
I've got this joke about a patient and a doctor.
Who'd have thought? Tell me!
After being examined, the patient asks, "Doctor, can you help me?" The doctor replies, "Of course, I'm going to prescribe you a mud bath." "And it'll help?" asks the patient. "Of course," the doctor says. "It'll help you get used to the feeling of being buried." Is that a good joke?
I don't know. It's only one way to find out.
Blout has told me a joke.
Blout's told me a joke, but it's a bit... coarse.
Perhaps a god of humor likes that sort of thing. Tell me.
Okay. There are these two statues, and they've been standing in a park opposite each other for hundreds of years. A young man and a young woman, both naked. One day, a god appears and fulfills their greatest wish. They're allowed to leave their plinths for an hour. They immediately disappear into the bushes. There's rustling, whispering, giggling. Then the woman gasps, "We've only got 10 minutes left." And the young man replies, "Okay, let's switch positions. You get hold of the pigeon and I'll crap on it."
That's good. It's got gods and statues in it.
Yeah, relatable. They can relate. That's the word I was looking for. What do I do with fireplace travel powder? How does it work?
I've never used fireplace travel powder before. How does it work?
You have to throw it in a fire. And then you walk into the flames and concentrate hard on the symbols of the fireplace in which you want to come out.
Aha. Uh-huh. And those are?
What symbols? You didn't answer her. So about those symbols on the library fireplace.
The icons on the fireplace in the library, you know.
I've never been there. Have you not memorized them?
It's Wilbur saying that.
Of course. They were...
Oh, it was Owl, Worm, Rat.
Owl, Worm, and Rat. I think.
I think, too.
You think?
I'm pretty sure. Unless it was a lion, polar bear, and caterpillar.
No, that wasn't it.
At least it wasn't eagle, mole, and penguin. Or was it?
All right, I'll give it a go. That's all for now.
See you later.
Didn't she have one other thing to ask him?
I don't know what I'd talk to Wilbur about right now. Hmm. And quite honestly, I'd rather only stick my head down there when absolutely necessary. I'll let them have some time on their own. They've got... Hi, you.
Oh, hello.
She still says hi to them, though. Let's go back and tell that joke before we try to go through the fireplace. Did she say anything different?
Ivo?
Yeah.
Nothing.
Right.
Ivo's there. Everything's fine.
Same thing. Okay. Down. And down.
I'll find Remy.
And down. Hmm. I'm gonna say a save here. I'm pretty sure the joke we want is the statues and the pigeon thing. And I do notice that Ivo made the, what do you call it? The voice. She chose a better word. She used the word crap instead of the other word.
Young friend, would you like to hear a joke?
No, but I'll tell you one. I think this is the one that he likes the most, so I'm going to tell him that last. I want to see his answer to these two. I know this joke about Hydra car thingies.
So, I heard this joke.
I'm listening.
So, two pieces of coal.
Mm.
One says, "Hello," whereupon the other says, "Ah, go away, you're substituted."
Are you sure that's how the joke goes?
No.
I want to retract my contribution.
I thought you might.
I know a joke about a patient and a doctor.
I have a joke.
Hit me.
This is a joke about a doctor and his patient. I think it's the only one of its kind. After being examined, the patient asks, "Doctor, can you help me?" The doctor replies, "Of course. I'm going to prescribe you a mud bath." "And it'll help?" asks the patient. "Of course," the doctor says. "It'll help you get used to the feeling of being buried."
That was even worse than the first one.
Oh, he didn't laugh.
Come on. That was good.
I think he didn't laugh at the other one.
Oh, sure. What does the God of Humour know about jokes? Did you see me laughing? No.
Okay. I know a joke with statues and gods. That has to make him laugh.
I know a joke with statues and gods. I'm sure you like it.
Oh, that sounds good.
For hundreds of years, these two statues are in a park opposite each other. One is a young man, the other a young woman.
We have to hear this three times, though.
So one day a god appears and grants them their greatest wish. They are permitted to leave their respective plinths for an hour. Both immediately disappear into the undergrowth. There's rustling, whispers, giggles. We've still got 10 minutes, the young man gasps. And she replies, great, let's switch places. You hold the pigeon and I'll crap on it.
That wouldn't even bring a tired smile to the faces of your audience.
Oh, come on.
But...
Well, to an audience with a sense of humor. There's only one of them here, and he didn't laugh.
Well, I thought my jokes were good and the others laughed. Perhaps it's you that doesn't have a sense of humor.
Well, I thought my jokes were good and the others laughed.
Oh, that's irrelevant. I have to laugh.
But you only seem to laugh at your own jokes.
Because they're the best ones.
But that's... Wait a minute.
Two cannibals are eating a clown.
Two cannibals are eating a clown?
It's his own joke.
And what does one say to the other?
He tastes a bit funny.
He tastes a bit funny! Oh, he tastes a bit... Oh, because he's a clown!
It's like you just heard it for the first time, isn't it?
That was a good joke, my friend. You made me laugh. Oh, so now I'll aid you, mortal.
Late.
Unless I counted wrong, I've now done three of you a favor. So, how do I cross the water?
Walk.
Ha ha! You might be able to walk on water, but I can't. And what about ice? Ice?
Is that just ice?
Haven't you noticed how cold it is here?
Give me a break. That's why
it
no boat
like ice.
Can cross it.
So?
And you couldn't have just told me that.
Would it have been as satisfying that way?
Probably not. But you'd better hope nothing happened to Remy just because you delayed me.
You guys serious?
Sure, there are lots of puzzles to solve. But he's more likely to throw new questions at me than help me answer old ones. I'm sure he could tell a great many stories. Long ones, too. But I'm worried about Remy. Hi.
Hello, my young friend.
I've got a glockenspiel here. Or maybe a xylophone. That's almost better than a tuning fork, don't you think?
Listen to this!
Not sure why I'm doing this. I've already got their favor.
Oh, the music. Notes. Semiquavers. Vibrato. It's all coming back to me.
Not bad, eh? I'm a natural.
That's it!
Uh-huh.
I thank you, mortal. I'm going to practice every day so that I don't forget the notes again.
Oh, great.
Now, I've even done all four of you a favor, even though you weren't very helpful.
Right.
The mark of a true hero is always to do more than he needs to, and to help everyone that he is able to help.
We should reward him.
Could you bring Remy here? Or transform the Archmage back?
Yeah, I got extra credit.
It wouldn't make for a particularly good story if a god suddenly intervenes and solves all the problems.
But it would be funny. Bang! Story over!
We want to present you with a laurel wreath of Hybness.
The hell's that?
Hey! We don't want to do that!
Well, I think that's a good idea.
Me too!
Take it, Wilbur, and wear it with pride. It is a sign you are a friend of the gods.
Okay. Oh, his wreath.
Thanks.
Very well. But look after it.
I'll look after it right now.
Given that I had to impress four gods to get this, I'm slightly underwhelmed by what I got.
Okay, we're wearing it. We got new headgear.
I'm sure he could tell, but I'm... Sure, there are a lot, but If I address him, he might tell me a joke. I don't really know what to ask her.
Okay, I can cross this now? I can just walk across these guys.
Remy must have figured out that the lake was frozen on his first expedition. He probably went straight to the temple.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. It looks like water, but it's actually ice. Child's play. No problem at all.
Oh, interesting.
Remy!
No, Wilbur. It's a trap.
Ooh. That's scary looking.
You will bring me the wand that this thief stole years ago.
I don't have that anymore. Who or what are you?
Who are you or what are you?
I am the gatekeeper.
Oh, good. I'm the keymaster.
You're the ghost of one of those mages that wanted to free the Nameless One, right?
The Nameless One must never be allowed to enter this world.
No? I mean, you're so right. Neither I nor Remy want that, so why are you fighting us?
He stole the wand. The wand is the key.
Look at that.
Bring me the key!
Let Remy go. He's injured.
Let Remy go free. He's badly injured.
He will die if you don't bring me the magic wand.
I don't have the magic wand anymore.
Then retrieve it. Your friend doesn't have much time.
Fetching the wand would take too long.
We don't have that much time. We have to...
Your friend is growing weaker by the second. Bring me the wand, or he will die.
But we can't!
Ooh. I've never seen a ghost that looks like that before.
I'll think of something, Remy!
I know you will, Wilbur.
Hey, we went all the way back.
Have to get Remy out of there as quickly as possible. He seemed so weak. Maybe I can somehow sneak past the ghost.
No, we need Ivo. Ivo has to fetch the Elder Wand.
I'll sneak back over to the island. Now I know what awaits me there. Maybe I can find a place to hide while I suss out the situation. Or maybe I can even go to get Remy without being noticed.
Doubt it. Oh, up here now. Oh, what's this done? Look at the arrangement.
I think this was once a mirror, just like the one over there.
Hmm.
I'm not sure. Maybe the cultists required either sun or moonlight for certain rituals and used the mirrors to reflect it down here. This mirror's broken. No trace of the shards. I think the mirrors can be adjusted.
Yeah.
But as long as the glass is broken, it's an unnecessary risk. It might squeak and the ghost could spot me.
Hmm.
I think the mirror... But
what if we replace... Oh, we don't have that anymore. Can't use this on anything. Oh, this mirror. Put the mirror on the stand.
The hand mirror is, of course, much smaller than the mirror that was in there before.
We do have it.
But it should be enough for a small beam of light.
Haha.
The light doesn't seem to bother him. He hasn't moved from the spot. The mirrors project the light on precisely the spot above which the ghost hovers. That could be useful. I won't move it.
I bet you he's actually a hologram. Look at Remy.
Oh, Remy. If I'd have gone with you, this never would have happened. Or if it had, I could have got help. Remy's very weak. He's in a lot of pain. Hang in there, old friend. I'll think of something.
So what is this thing?
That's probably the strange machine that cultists wanted to use for things.
Like a bomb or something.
Doesn't look like it's been used recently. The ghost called the wand the key. I wonder if this machine is the lock. No idea how far down it goes. The cellar master spoke of caves and crevices reaching hundreds, sometimes thousands of meters down into the ground.
Wow, huh?
The beam of moonlight really emphasizes just how dark it is down here. Now the glow is directly beneath the ghost. Doesn't seem to bother it. Now the glow is doesn't seem... What a dreadful creature. The ghost lured Remy into a trap and now it's using me to get the magic wand.
So I'm hitting the frame rate here.
There's no negotiating with the ghost. It wants the wand and is willing to let Remy die for it. I can't let that happen. I have to expel the ghost somehow, or cast a spell over it. The god of story said the ghost never leaves the island. Maybe it can't. I'll just need a few minutes, then I can free Remy and get him to safety.
If it is a real ghost, they're usually bound to the places in which they've died. Of course, I've never seen a ghost like this before.
There's no negotiating with... The mirrors project the light on precisely the spot. That could be useful.
Can I move over there? No. I want to look at this thing too. That looks pretty interesting.
Remy's very hung in there.
Well, I don't know what else I can do at this point. We do still have to get Ivo into the through the fireplace. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.